The Great Lakes hold an incredible collection of shipwrecks, and each tells a fascinating story. But how are they studied? I went to the Thunder Bay National Marine Sanctuary to find out.
The Great Lakes are dotted with thousands of shipwrecks, some hundreds of years old. They all offer information about the history of the Great Lakes. Shipwrecks can be found by accident, but the scientific techniques for finding and studying them involve hard work, persistence, and good old arithmetic. I recently traveled to the Thunder Bay National Marine Sanctuary in Alpena, Michigan, to sit in on an archaeology field school course. I learned a lot about how sunken ships are studied and documented, and I even got to do some of it myself.
Hey, Ward.
Hey, good to see you.
Hi.
Thanks for having us up here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah.
Welcome to Alpena.
Minutes after arriving at the sanctuary, I was put to work assembling an ROV, or remotely operated vehicle. These underwater robots are a big part of the project.
Very delicate work.
The students are with Dr. Ashley Lemke, a professor of archaeology at the University of Texas Arlington. They're here to learn underwater mapping skills used in archaeology, specifically locating and studying shipwrecks. With my ROV all built, it was time to put it to the test.
It could have been a disaster otherwise.
We'll very delicately put your ROV in and see how it goes. One of the students will help you out with your cable so it will stay out of the way. And then you're doing it. You're piloting your ROV.
And if you want to go in a straight line, push them both at the same time.
Oh, no.
Playing with a hand-built ROV in a small pool is important.
I'm like all turned around.
You need to practice maneuvering this device before trying to drive a real ROV around shipwrecks in Lake Huron. The waves and the lake currents can make it tricky to steer the vehicle. Next lesson, crunching some numbers.
Ward, I'm going to have you join this team right here, Ashley and Jonathan, so you guys can work together and create your surveys.
I worked with a couple of students to create a survey pattern. This is an important tool that's used a lot in underwater archaeology to find sunken vessels. A boat with a sonar scanner will follow this path to map areas of the lake bottom or shipwreck sites.
That's just where we are.
It's kind of like a starting point, and then
so we just
build,
put that as like the middle.
You build from there.
And we know we need to get at least 50 meters in either direction.
Yeah, but...
But maybe a little more.
Without a survey pattern for the boat to follow, it's like doing a cross-country drive without a map. Dr. John O'Shea is an anthropology professor at the University of Michigan. He's explored many shipwrecks and is considered an expert in Great Lakes archaeology.
And what we did with the students is basically kind of threw them in and said, okay, here are the pieces of information you need to know. This is the size of the boat. This is about where we think it is in UTM coordinates. Design us a survey.
Using side-scan sonar, the research boat called Blue Traveler will follow the survey patterns the students create. The sonar data can then be used to produce a 3D digital picture like this one that shows what lies on the bottom of the lake.
So we just spent time in the classroom planning out our route for the scan.
Right.
And now do we go put it into practice and see what we find?
Yeah, absolutely. So it's a lot of classroom time making those maps and getting your routes all together. But one of the most exciting things is then to actually go and get to drive that route on the boat and tow the sonar behind you and see what you find.
Cool. Well, let's go find a shipwreck.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's
go. Awesome.
You guys ready?
Yep.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Thunder Bay National Marine Sanctuary includes 4,300 square miles of Lake Huron's waters and almost 100 named shipwrecks. Today, we're tying off the Blue Traveler on a buoy marking the wreck of the Harvey Bissell, a wooden three-masted schooner barge that sprang a leak and sank in November of 1905. It rests just a few hundred yards offshore. Now is the moment of truth. I get to pilot an ROV around a real shipwreck, and this ROV has a name, Jake.
Hey, Jake.
This is him.
Jake is a much more sophisticated version of what I built in the classroom. Jake even has his own Facebook page with more than 100 fans.
So is he pretty much together? Like, do you have to do any stuff besides hook the cable up?
All you gotta do is he has a manipulator, that claw out in front. You just kind of loosen it and angle it to where you want it to go. So this goes here, and that's what connects him to the boat.
Jake gets hooked up to a 500-foot cable and then is sent overboard to do some exploring.
There he goes. See you, Jake.
ROVs like Jake are an important tool for giving researchers an up-close view of wrecks and other underwater features.
Out of all the technology we use, underwater archaeology is so technology heavy, but the ROV is one of the most important things because it gives you a picture of the bottom, you know? You'll have sonar maps, so you have an idea of what's going on, but this is the first time with Jake where you really see things, you know, the way that you would see it if you were scuba diving.
One of the really cool things about the Great Lakes, of course, it's the freshwater, right?
Yeah.
So it preserves these wrecks much better than saltwater would for a similar wreck. It's really cool. These wrecks had such a long life where they were kind of used and then they were kind of rebuilt and something else and then used again. So you can see this history, this life history, really, of this one shipwreck just by looking at it this way.
After a long day of working underwater, it was time to bring Jake back home. The cable is reeled in and Jake is carefully lifted out of the water and placed on the deck of the boat. As valuable as Jake is, it's the Blue Traveler's sonar that will scan the wreck and create a 3D image that will go into the archives of the Thunder Bay National Marine Sanctuary. The students and I have learned a lot by the time Captain O'Shea fires up the engines and heads for home.
Archaeology is one of those fields that everyone always thinks of happening elsewhere. You know, you always think of archaeology in Egypt or Rome or these faraway places. And one of the most important things for me as an archaeologist, like, I work in the States. I work where I grew up, you know, or I work where I teach, or I work where I went to school. So archaeology is all over the place.
Shipwrecks are very evocative because every shipwreck, every historic shipwreck at least, has a story. And it is, you know, you may know the names of the people, the captain, where it was going, where it was coming from. In fact, the reason I got involved in shipwreck archaeology had to do with the remains of a vessel that turned up on our beach on Lake Huron, and a bunch of jet skiers were there ripping timbers off it to sell as shipwreck timber. And this just mortally offended me. If you rip that stuff up, we may never be able to identify the boat, and if we can't identify the boat, we can't put the story back with it.
Well, the good news is not only did we have good weather, but we had a really good survey too.
Awesome.
It was really great.
Obviously, it was all the students who, you know, were the reason for the success, but now what do you do with that image? How is that used?
So our work today is actually gonna go in their archives. So they're gonna have a brand new, really great survey, a really great map of that shipwreck, and then people who are coming, archaeologists or the public, can see this really beautiful image of one of the wrecks that's just
out. Oh, that's
out
awesome.
Here.
So it actually can get used in real scientific work.
Yeah, absolutely. If you wanna switch careers and be an archaeologist, let me know.
No.
I'll put you to work.
We'll see how things go.
Yeah.
But thanks so much for having us. At Great Lakes Now, we aim to cover the Great Lakes region and the people who live here, like you. Please follow us on social media, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and sign up for our newsletter at greatlakesnow.org.